Next, and I want to bring in Congressman Ed Royce, Republican of California and Chairman of the House Foreign Affairs Committee. He is currently on the ground in Kiev. Congressman, thanks so much for being with us. You know the situation on the ground. Do you think the White House is doing enough right now?
Well, I do not. I think the main point they're missing is what has put Putin in the driver's seat over here is the fact that he controls oil and gas. He's got a monopoly on it. And that would be something we can upset. We could upset it by announcing a national policy in the United States that we're going to ship a tremendous amount of gas. Yes, it would take a little while to get up to speed. But if we sent the message that we were going to help collapse Russia's hold over the region and the price of oil in the region or gas by destabilizing the markets. Remember, it's 70% of Russia's exports. It's 52% of what they need to support their military and their government. And this, you've got to strike Putin at a point which will really weaken him. And energy security here in the region is a big concern in Eastern Europe. We need to move decisively on that front.
It's Congressman, do you agree with senators?
As a matter of fact. And my hope.
Do you agree with Senators McConnell and Corker that we should be sending lethal aid to the Ukrainian military?
You know, frankly, in my opinion, what we should be focused on is what long term will really damage Russia's economy and give us leverage over Vladimir Putin. We haven't used that yet. And that's, as I said, to discuss a national plan and at the same time to get over here and give the Ukrainians the wherewithal to help develop their own gas. Because frankly, the real question is going to be, can we hold these elections on May 25th, which will hold the country together? Because frankly, the new polling shows in the eastern part of the country, they don't want to be part of Russia, right? You're going to have a 70% vote at least in order from the east to be part of a new system in which they can elect their own governors, where they can elect representatives. You've got the electoral reform coming, but you've got to do something about energy. That's what we discussed, our delegation today, with the Vice President of the United States here, and we want to move forward. We've been stymied by opposition on this front. We think the administration may be rethinking its position because this, frankly, is what gives Russia the real authority in Ukraine.
Congressman, beyond the energy issue, what is the Ukrainian government there telling you? What do they want from the U.S.? Do they think that they can hold off an invasion from Russia if it were to come?
Well, the point is, the way you deter an invasion from Russia is you show the Russians what the consequences would be to their economy, right? What would economic collapse look like? They've experienced it once before. Reagan, along with the Saudis, helped do this to the former Soviet Union, drove down the price of oil by flooding their market with very cheap oil in order to really hurt that economy. If you do that, Gazprom stock and the stock market in Russia really takes a nosedive, as does the value of the ruble. They're running a situation over there on a pretty thin tightrope right now in Russia, because already the capital flight has been over $70 billion over the last few months. So if we send the threat of additional sanctions, which is what we're communicating, we're saying, look, you do that, you know, you go over the border with your military, and the U.S. and Europe and the international community is going to isolate you in a way with sanctions that are just going to implode your economy. That's the most effective leverage we have to deploy. If we can combine energy security for the region with that, we will give the Europeans a lot more confidence to stand, you know, in unison on this front, and we will further undercut Russia's control in Ukraine.
Congressman Ed Royce in Ukraine, thank you so much. Travel safe, sir. Coming up.